We go now to Nashville and Senator Marco Rubio. Senator, you're saying that it's now a three-man race. That means to get to the nomination, you have to get past Donald Trump. Is that just going to happen, or do you have to make that happen?
No, you have to make that happen. But part of the dynamic up to this point is Donald has been, you know, in the mid-30s to low-30s, high-20s in most polls. And then you have 70% of the Republican electorate that says we're not voting for him. But they're divided up among five or seven people. So as that five or seven people continues to narrow down, I think it's going to make the race clearer and clearer. Of course, we still have to go out and earn that vote. And by the way, there are people supporting Donald Trump that we believe we can win over as well. And so it is a smaller race and field today than it was last night. I think practically speaking, it is down to three people who are still running full-scale national campaigns. I have tremendous respect for Governor Carson. I know he's going to stay in the race and continue to fight. And I know John Kasich is out there basically going to spend a week in Michigan and make that his priority. But today alone, we're going to be in three states, and we're going to continue to campaign everywhere. And we feel really good about this coalescing. And of course, if anyone wants to join our effort, they should go to our website, marcorubio.com. We need their help.
How are you going to take those voters away from Donald Trump, as you say? What's your argument?
Well, I think here's the argument. Number one, I'm very realistic about the challenges we face. Okay, I've seen it up close. In 2010, it's why I ran for the Senate 5 years ago. I've only been there 5 years, but it's been enough time to know the damage Barack Obama has done to this country. But while I'm realistic about our challenges, I'm optimistic about our future. There are a few things, and if we do them, we're going to have the greatest era in our history. And I've detailed what those things are specifically. And I think that's important. If you're running to be president of the United States, you can't just tell people you're going to make America great again. I think you need to begin to explain exactly how you're going to do it policy-wise. We're not going to win a general election with a candidate that refuses to detail policy. Obviously, Donald still has time to do that, and then we can have a policy debate about whose ideas are better. But I honestly believe that once people begin to understand what's at stake here, that we have a chance here not just to make our country great, but greater than it's ever been, and we have a plan to do it, I think that's going to begin to influence a lot of voters, not to mention coalesce those who maybe were with someone else first around us.
You want Mr. Trump to be more specific, offer more policies. People have been asking about that for him for months. And in the polls, what it shows is that voters seem to be flocking to him because they think he's the stronger candidate on issues of national security. So are people wrong about that? How do you convince them they're not right to be for Trump because he's stronger?
Well, I think strong rhetoric and strong action are two separate things. Anyone can use tough words. Anyone can go over the top and say things that sound strong. But sounding strong is not enough. You have to know exactly how you're going to do it. And if you look at some of the policies he's talked about, they would not make America stronger. His views on Vladimir Putin, I think, are troubling. And I don't think he fundamentally understands exactly who Vladimir Putin is or exactly what he's trying to do. So these are the kinds of things that I think in detail you begin to understand. When you're the commander in chief, you're the commander in chief on day one. You don't get like a, you know, 6 month grace period. The world doesn't just stop and say, well, let's wait till the president catches up before we start challenging America. You've got to know what you're doing on your very first day there. So look, this is not an attack or anything of that nature. It's just a very simple observation. If you want to be president, you have to start detailing some specific public policy. And I don't think from this point forward in the campaign, voters are going to be as tolerant of the lack of that as they've been up to now.
What else other than on Vladimir Putin would you expect to see specific policy from him on?
Oh, I mean, on everything, about on health care. I mean, we all agree we're going to repeal Obamacare, but what will you replace it with? And that's something we've detailed. He is not. I think, again, on issues of energy, how are we going to fully utilize our energy resources in this country? What is the role of the federal government in higher education? What kind of justices would you appoint to the Supreme Court? Not just because we have a vacancy now, but at least one or two potentially in the next 4 to 8 years. I mean, on virtually every major issue before this country, that is the natural purview of the federal government, it is important to have some specificity about what you're going to do if you want to be the president. And so I agree that up until this point, it hasn't been a huge factor, but it will be moving forward. And let me just say this. The Democrats, if we nominate someone who's nebulous about these things, they're going to eat our lunch in November. And so we have to absolutely have someone ready to go that can win, because we cannot lose this election. Hillary Clinton or Bernie Sanders cannot be the next president of the United States.
Last question on politics. There have been three contests. You have yet to win one. Is there a danger that you're everybody's second choice?
No, I don't think so, because as I explained earlier, when you have seven or eight people competing for the same chunk of votes, it's a lot of votes, but you have seven or eight people, it's all segmented. I think now that the race begins to narrow, you're going to have a clear indication of it. And as we looked at this race, we understood that this narrowing had to happen before the winner-take-all states that'll begin in the middle of March. So we feel good about the states we're going into and the process they award delegates by, and we're in real good shape. We got to keep working hard.
All right, Senator Marco Rubio, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.